Australian ship Dundee 01, ready to kick ass.
Spitfire reporting in.
Hang in there, W. Canada, I'm joining the battle.
This is a direct violation of the International Space Treaty that you all signed, every single one of you.
We're joining the battle.
That was supposed to be destroyed. This is an outrage. You're all liars, just like my ex-husband.
Come down, lady, come down.
Don't you lady me, Pinko. Okay, who didn't arm their spaceships? Oh, great. Great, that's just great. You all gave me your word.
But you broke yours.
We always break ours, this is what we do. Okay, fine. Let's just beat the shit out of these bricks and talk about the details later. I knew you could do it. Be foxy and salacious all the way. Congratulations.
What's helium-3?
Helium.
Did you say helium-3?
Yeah, there's like 15 to 20 giant towers that appear to be full of the stuff.
That's ours.
It is? Why?
Helium-3 would make the U.S. independent of all energy needs for the next 1,000 years.
Oh. Yes, it's ours. No. Hear me out. The moon is American soil. Moon flag, stars and stripes. Who beat the moon Nazis? We did. Well, yeah. All right, you helped out here and there, but ultimately, it's just like World War II, and who won that? We did!
You lie!
You don't believe me? Watch the movies. Movies don't lie. Knock the shoot, Jesus!
This is the Secretary of Defense. Defend and hold that helium-3 at all costs!
But against who?
Against everybody!
Unfortunately, that's the story of revenge. It's messy. It never really works out the way you want it to. I feel lonely.